हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू अनदर एपिसोड ऑफ टेकी ट्यूजडेज। आई एम योर होस्ट एंड कोच एस रवि कुमार। टेकी ट्यूजडेज इज अ वीकली शो वेयर आई आंसर योर टेक एंड करियर रिलेटेड क्वेरीज। सो इफ यू लाइक माय आंसर्स, देन प्लीज हिट दैट लाइक बटन, सब्सक्राइब टू माय चैनल एंड शेयर दिस वीडियो विद योर फ्रेंड्स, फैमिली एंड कलीग्स। लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड विद टुडेज क्वेश्चंस। Today's first question is asked by Anubhav. He's asking, I am confused in choosing my career in the technology field. Which specialization is best for getting success in my career? Anubhav, haven't you heard that very popular dialogue of Three Idiot movie that success ke piche mat bhago bachcha, excellence ke piche bhago. Success jhak maar ke tumhare piche aayegi. Which means that don't run behind anything which will make you successful. Run behind something which will give you excellence. So choose a technology whichever you like or whichever you love to work on and get excellence in that technology. You will obviously get successful in that. If you ask for my opinion, I will always say you that read C#, .NET and Microsoft technologies, because C# and .NET is there in market since last 20 years and it's going to stay in the market for another 50 to 100 years. Next question is from Kishore. He is asking, how can I start a computer programming career after 40 in India? Kishore, if you want to become a hobby programmer or if you want to work on a friend's application, like one of your friend requires something related to programming and you want to create that program, then of course you can learn programming and you can do that. However, if you are looking for a job as a fresher in a software company at the age of 40, then I'm sorry to say that you can't get that job, because no company in India will hire a 40-year-old fresher. Usually, company hires directly from the colleges itself and then they train people in whatever language or whatever framework they work. At the age of 40, even seasoned programmers in India move either towards managerial role or towards architectural role. Of course, architectural roles demand learning new languages or new technology, but they have to use the similar concepts or they have to learn about the core concepts of something. They don't have to do actual programming. So in my opinion, you should stick to whatever work you are doing. And if you want to learn computer programming, learn it as a hobby, but don't look for a job in computer programming at the age of 40, at least not in India. Next question is from Samiksha. She's asking, currently I am working for a startup and they are paying me fine salary. However, I got selected for a consulting company whose client is Oracle, and if I accept this job, I would be working for Oracle client. I am unable to decide what to do. Samiksha, if you are satisfied with your current job and your current package, as you said that you are getting a fine salary. So if you are satisfied with your current job responsibilities and your current package in the startup, then in my opinion, you should stick to that job and you shouldn't join this new company or new consulting company, because even though your client will be Oracle, still he will just be a client and you will be just as a consultant. So it doesn't count much. In a way, I can say that I have worked with many Fortune 500 clients, but I am not employee of that particular client or that particular company. So you won't be getting any benefit from joining this consulting company. You will be just a consultant. But in this startup, and I am assuming that this is an actual product startup, so you must be getting some learning about the business and some learning about the product. So if you are getting a good learning in this product startup, then in my opinion, you should stick to this product startup instead of moving to a consulting company and then just joining it for the sake that you will be working for Oracle. Next question is from Rushil Anand. He's asking, should I pursue a degree or diploma or aim for certificate if I want to pursue a career in UI UX design? I don't have enough money to pursue a full-time degree which cost around 10,000 euro per year. Please be brutally honest and accurate. Which one is best? Rushil, to be very frank and to be brutally honest, A UX or UI designer is identified by his or her portfolio designs, not by what degree or what diploma he has done. Even though in India, many companies require degree to join a job, but they don't consider a particular specialization degree. So any bachelor's degree will do for getting a job. However, if you have diploma or if you have a certificate and you have good design skills, which you can showcase with the help of your portfolio or with your dribble profile. So from there, if a person can identify your designs, then I think you are golden to get a good job. So do whatever comes in your budget, be it a diploma or be it a degree or be it a certificate, but make sure that your designs stand out. So focus on learning how to create good design, how to create good user experience and user interfaces, rather than focusing on the degree that from where you are getting the degree. So if you want to get a degree, you can go for a cheaper degree also. I don't know which degree cost 10,000 euros per year. So you can go for a cheaper degree, which comes much more lesser than in this. Probably go for a distance learning degree. But focus on learning, focus on creating good design, create a good dribble profile or any design site, because I'm sorry, I just know about dribble where most of the designers showcase their designs. So like I just know about that site. So I would suggest that create a good dribble profile, create good designs of probably replicas or probably whatever design themes you think of some popular sites. Like you can say that in my opinion, Instagram should look like this, or Netflix should look like this, or Amazon Prime app should look like this. So you can create a concept design of your own and create a profile of that and showcase that thing along with learning this degree or diploma, whatever you choose. So do whatever comes in your budget, but go for excellence in that instead of just earning the degree. Next question is from Ashutosh Yadav. He's asking, how do I learn coding while working in a non-IT sector job? Ashutosh, it primarily depends on how much time and how much money you have. There are many sites like Upgrad or Coursera which teaches you programming along with giving a degree from an Indian or a foreign university. But they charge you more. Then there are websites like Pluralsight or Udemy from where you can just learn the programming, but you won't get any certificate. So first find out your budget, that what is your budget. Then you have to choose, like based on your budget, you can choose any of these sites, be it Udemy, be it Pluralsight, be it Coursera, or be it Upgrad. So choose the site of your choice and then spend 2 to 3 hours daily in learning and practicing programming, and you can learn coding very easily. Next question is from Vishakha. She is asking, how can I approach a work from home flexible IT software job with no experience? Vishakha, after March 2020, or you can say after the corona pandemic lockdown, 90% of IT software jobs are work from home flexible. And the only way to join an IT company without any experience is to join it as an intern. So there are many sites like Internshala, or you can go to Naukri.com or Monster.com and look for internship opportunities in an IT company or software company. So you have to join them as an intern. Then so intern is the only position in which they can hire a person without any experience. Otherwise, you will have to build your experience first and then look for a job. Next question is from Anish Narayan. He's asking, what is your opinion about the statement, engineers prefer command line, GUI is for non-engineers? Anish, it's a toxic bro culture statement to showcase the supremacy of engineering degree. In programming, it doesn't matter whether you use GUI or whether you use command line. What matter actually is how good you write the program, how performant is that program, and if you are creating a GUI, how good looking that GUI is. So So it has nothing to do with your command line or using a GUI. I have seen many engineers using GUIs and I have seen many non-engineers using command line. So it's all of a personal choice. And frankly speaking, if GUI was not that popular, then why companies were building so big IDEs? Or why companies were spending money in creating the IDEs for different languages and frameworks? So in my opinion, this statement is nothing but just a toxic bro culture supremacy showing statement. Nothing else. Next question is from Rakesh. He's asking, can you run Windows on an Apple M1 Mac using the Bootcamp Assistant? Rakesh, I came to know about this yesterday only by watching the review video of a MacBook Mini and a MacBook Pro based on M1 chip, Apple M1 chip. And in that review video, the reviewer said that Apple has stopped support of Windows or stop support of Bootcamp from M1 Macs, because Windows operating system is primarily written for Intel chips, and the ARM version of Windows is not that good. Then I searched about this also over the internet, and these reports and these things are true about Apple M1 Macs, that they don't support Windows installation using Bootcamp. Next question is from Alisha Dash. She's asking, what role does LinkedIn play in your career and how do you find it useful? Alisha, LinkedIn is basically a professional social networking site. So LinkedIn will not give you a short-term result like Naukri, that you can't get a job change or you can't go for a job change in a short term by just creating a LinkedIn profile. But if you are keeping your LinkedIn profile up to date with the updated things what you are doing, and you are connected with your old colleagues and other peoples in the community, then of course it will help you in getting job references and getting yourself noticed in the industry. So basically LinkedIn will help you in the professional career in the same way as Facebook will help you in the personal career. To build a following, to build your personal brand, and to grow yourself as a professional. So in my opinion, everyone should keep their LinkedIn profile always up to date with recommendations from their seniors or their ex-colleagues, and they should showcase whatever they are doing in their career on their LinkedIn profile if their company policies allow them to share that. Otherwise, if someone is writing a blog or someone is creating a YouTube video like me, they can post about those things on LinkedIn if those things are basically professional, if those things are their profession. So like I create technical YouTube videos, so I post these videos on YouTube also, on LinkedIn also, so that more and more people should know about me and the technology which technology knowledge which I am here to share. Next question is from Satish. He's asking, why do clients expect unreal project deadlines? Satish, because they are clients and they are paying money for it. Let me help you understand this with the help of an example. Let's say you go to the restaurant and you order something to eat. What will you expect from the person who is serving you? That your food comes to you as soon as possible. But it's the job of the person who is serving you food that how much time will that food will take to prepare and come to your table. So basically he will tell that chef is currently busy with other orders, or chef is currently working on your dish, or your dish has so many things involved in it that it will take this much amount of time to prepare it, and then only it will come to you. That's why they say that, sir, your order will take minimum 10 to 15 minutes, because that much time will required for them to bake that thing or to cook that thing. In the same way, client's expectation is that they should get their projects as soon as possible. Every client has the same expectation because of this current culture of early gratification. Everybody wants their things as soon as possible. So client will say that, yes, I want my project or my product to be delivered as soon as possible. It's your responsibility or it's your project manager's responsibility to explain to the client that the project will take at least this much amount of time to be built because you require these things to build that project. So client expect unrealistic project deadlines because project managers agree to those unrealistic project deadlines. If project manager push back and project manager says that it is not possible to deliver this project within these deadlines, then client will not say that I need this project. Or they can say that, okay, even if we deliver this project in these deadlines, it won't be a quality product. So the product will not work or product will not fulfill all the condition of quality requirement we need in this particular amount of time. What max or what worst can happen? Client will go to someone else, but that someone else, if he agrees to do in that particular time, he will face the same problem because he's not delivering him the quality product. So once the client is burned from that person, they will come back to you. So if you are giving a genuine example or genuine explanation, a proper explanation with proper reasoning, with proper examples that this project will take this much time, then there is no way that client will expect some unrealistic deadline. So in a nutshell, client will always expect unrealistic deadline. It's your job as a project manager to explain them and make those deadlines a realistic one. So these were my answer to your tech and career related queries in this episode of Techie Tuesdays. If you want your questions to be answered in next episode of Techie Tuesdays, you can DM me your questions on any social media platform with hashtag Techie Tuesdays. All my social media handles are Techie Rathor, which you can see here. I hope you like my answers. And if you like my answers, then please hit that like button, subscribe to my channel, and share this video with your friends, family, and colleagues. So until my next video, take care. Bye-bye.